I learned many great lessons from my father, not the least of which was that if you fail at what you don't want, you might as well take a chance at doing what you love. And just doing what you love is the topic of today that we will speak about. There are two types of people in the world. People who do not know what to do, but there are a lot of people who are restricted by their mindset. They still not able to figure out what they want to do in life. So let me share a couple of facts with you today. We are living in the golden era of humanity. We have good jobs, more money, expensive cars, we have branded clothes, the life expectancy is all high, healthcare is booming, technology is growing, economy is far stable, we have communication at our fingertips. Global problems are either being solved or are under control, and now they are even back to problems aren't. But despite all these things, why do we still trip? We need to realize, we need to look inside us, are we really happy? Despite all these things, branded clothes, expensive cars, jobs, everything being so happy, why are we still tripping? Why things are not going right? Why things are not happening correctly in our own life? And this is another point, which is that even smaller startups, smaller businesses are successful. Smaller startups are funded. Not all artists are happy. Not all your poets and singers and different kind of people are also not great. Do you realize something is missing out there? Is it not becoming a rat and not being a rat race, becoming a rat race? This is a very important key ingredient which is missing to the entire scenario and what I'm going to talk about today depends upon that. Warren Buffett once said that taking up job to build a resume is like saving up text for old age. And that is what we are doing today. The entire scenario which is happening today, we are running after job to, and running after money to get a better package and better job and have a better lifestyle. But we are not building things for tomorrow. So let me share a couple of stories with you. And which is what I want to talk about this particular thing, which is do what you love. Because I personally, philosophically believe in this concept of do what you love. But most of the people perceive do what you love as wrong. They think that waking up late is do what you love. Not going to college is do what you love. Dropping out is do what you love. But do what you love is far more demanding, far more challenging, and it's something which needs a lot of hard work. So there are two things which will help you do something what you love. Number one, skills. And this is a very important thing I want to share with you today. So I consult and meet a lot of startups. I work with a lot of startups. I have been into the people which are from a long, long time. I meet four kinds of people. There are people who come to me and say, can you help me? I don't have an idea. The people who come to me and say, I have so many ideas. The people who come to me and say, I have an idea, don't know what to do next. And the people who come to me and say, I have an idea, I'll not share it with you. Because you might take it and run away. What takes an idea to become a business or a startup or to become successful? All of us know this word and it's a cliche, execution. We have heard thousand stories that execution is important. But how are you going to execute? How? So acquiring the right skill set is very, very, very important whenever it comes to doing what you love. If you want to become an entrepreneur, you have to learn how to do business. If you want to become an artist or a painter or a dancer or a musician or whatever, you have to learn the core skill of what you want to do. I recently wrote an article on LinkedIn about a very famous personality, and I think one of the reasons that Shantanu wrote this and called it TEDx was that, and the famous personality was Mr. Pooja. And I say to people that if you just follow passion but do not have a skill set, I repeat, if you just follow passion but do not have the right skill set, you'll end up like Mr. Pooja. You'll end up mediocre. You will be famous for 2 days, 3 days, and also because half the people are laughing at you. To become somebody like Lata Mangeshkar or somebody like Sachin Tendulkar or somebody who has excelled in his field, skill is the most important part, number one. Number two is the passion, of course. The approach has to be skill first and passion later, and not passion first and skill later. But why do we need passion? Aren't all the engineers skillful? Aren't all the painters getting into the basic job done? Aren't they skillful? Aren't all the carpenters skillful? See, the passion is going to fly in the long run. The skill set will help you to kick start, but the passion will help you to fly in the long run. If you are passionate about something, not even, and I really hate this term for retirement. And I see so many people, you know, fancying about, there is so much of, you know, bad into the ecosystem now. You'll find so many people think, hey, I retired at 40, I'll retire at 40, I retired at 35, at 25 I'm retired. Anybody who's actually following his passion, following his dream, following a bigger goal, will never retire. Look at anybody, either from India or the international ecosystem. Look at Ratan Tata, look at Dhirubhai Ambani, look at Bill Gates, look at Steve Jobs, he was fighting cancer, and he was, you know, on the stage, you know, launching a massive air. Why didn't he retire? He was already billionaire. So skill set is going to help you take start. Passion will help you to go long run. There's another very important point I want to tell you here, and you know, this all would side sound like too much of gyan, right? This is very general basic gyan that yes, okay, now you have jumped up for TEDx, you of course speak about skill, you give it a topic, you come on passion. So I'll tell you my life story. And I'll be more than happy to take something out of it. And I believe whatever I have done in my life till date, that has only happened because I really believed in doing it. I believe in acquiring the right skills. I believe in doing it. Passionately, of course. So my journey, personally, if you ask me, began when I was in like fourth grade, and that was like I was first at exposed to a computer. And of course, and I'm talking about early 90s, having a computer at your home with a black cross screen, you can type and write commands. It was a fancy thing to show off. And I'm not talking about kids who have an iPhone, an iPad, or a MacBook, or a tablet today. I'm talking about early 90s when, you know, forget internet, there was no computer. And that is what fascinated me. More than that, what fascinated me was the fear of curiosity, that how does it function? And I started understanding and I started writing code. And the first transaction of that skill set happened when I was in class 6. Back in school days, that time, and I think most of you would, you know, happy to that phase, we are being taught something called creative, the programming language. And I was the only one who had a computer at my place and I could practice, and I started charging 5 rupees per program for my classes. And eventually, what happened at the end of the day, that after the end of the year, you know, the computer teacher knew that I am writing on the program. So rather than, you know, getting after my life, he said that, okay, I'll not take any paper, if he's written it, they must be right. So that is the implementation of skill and depth, that is what gave me the first break. And since then, I've been writing computer code, building up on multiple things, you know, requiring multiple skills into computer, and that is what gave me my second break when I was in college. In my first year, back in my college days, I came in top 3 in the computer science computer competition, coding program competition, and my peers, my people came first and second, first from like Delhi. And have been learning computers in their core curriculum for a long, long, long time. Have you ever felt that small thing in your brain? That eureka moment? That something that hits you? That something has happened today? That yes, I have done something or did something? That was that moment for me. It was really shocking for somebody like me who came from a TLP, so I from Kota. That somebody who never had computer science in his mainstream school can read kids from Delhi learning computer science full time. And that is when I started my computer club in college, and then eventually started the first company back in college days. So still, and you keep on building on top of that. So I was very passionate about writing program, and that is why I started the company writing code and capturing all those things. Another very important thing I will talk about, again from my journey, which I again personally feel and understand that as well, is that if you are really good at something, and this is what I get to all the entrepreneurs, especially people who are working in the skill domain. Like, what is the skill domain? You're not building a product or a software, you're doing something which is basically a guitarist or a painter or a dancer. Somebody who has got individual skill set. Is that if you're really good at something, and I mean good, really, really good at something, you can always teach and learn. If you're really good at something, you can always teach people and earn money. So during that sudden phase, when you're not really famous, when you're not getting stage shows, if you're really passionate towards doing it, you would definitely be able to teach more people, attract more people, and make little money out of it. And that is where I started my second company, because I was passionate for teaching as well. So we made good about money by starting the second company, because we were already coding for 5 years. And then we started the second company. So, my summary of the entire this do what you love thing is that you need to acquire the right skill set if you really want to pursue do what you love. Number two, it is really, really, really passionate towards doing it. But how does this come at a cost? Doing what you love and pursuing something you're passionate about comes at a cost. Let's look at the people who are working in a regular job, who are working with certain multinationals. They have already purchased their homes and a fancy car, and people who are my colleagues back in college and in India, Argentina, have settled in US. And this is where passion drives you. I don't like and why I'm talking specifically about startups is because that is the domain I work in. So it's like, I meet a lot of startup guys, young guys saying, it's not working out. I don't know whether my startup will function or not. And then I ask them, are you full time into it? No. Yes. Since how long have you been working it? We're working on this particular thing. 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 6 months, year. I'm changing what I want for the past 10 years and I don't think I'm still yet close to it. This is a cost that you bear when it comes to doing what you love. So although, you know, media and, you know, news and everything is glorified in doing what you love back, so I meet a lot of kids who say, we don't want people to, you know, go to regular college and they want to drop on it, you know, what you love, but that doing what you love is also becoming a rat race. So don't drop out. Don't stop following the conventional path. You're not mentally ready for to be at this way. I just have one last quotation to conclude. In fact, I have two quotations to conclude my entire talk. The first quote comes from this movie called The Founder, and it says that Nothing in this world can take place of cold, good persistence. Talent world. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful lack of talent. Genius world. Unrecognized genius is practically appreciated. Education world. The world is full of educated people. Persistence and determination are all powerful. If you're really persistent and passionate and determined towards doing what you love, of course, with the right skill set and building upon that skill set, there is nothing stopping you. So I'll conclude with this one famous quote of Steve Jobs. And yes, I'm one of his biggest fans. And he says that when you grow up, you can pretend to be told that the world is the way it is, and your life is just to live your life inside the world. Try not to bash into the walls too much. Try to have a nice family, have fun, save a little money. That's it. That's very limited life. Life can be broader once you discover one simple fact. Everything around you that you call life was made by people that were no smarter than you. And you can change it, you can influence it, you can build your own thing that other people can do. Once you learn this simple fact, you will never win the game again. So, quotes, telling that what you need to do from now on is to build, execute, and acquire the right skill set so that you can actually do what you love. Thank you.